Hello everyone. My name is Björgvin Sævarsson. I am a founder and CEO of the Kala Group. Mayor, thank you for the invitation. Grant, appreciate being here. For someone who's a bit of a history, I appreciate history. It's really nice to be here for the first time. I have a bit of an accent. Grew up in Iceland and moved about 16 years ago to Minneapolis and traveled the country all over the place. Learned a lot of strange things when I came here first. 60% of our drinking water polluted. 4 or 5 years later, it was 70%. Then we stopped measuring it. Why are we doing that? You know, I didn't think any more about it at the time, but figured that there are ways to do better. One of the first things I learned coming to America was we have organization, we have a system. There's a lot of police here. There's also religion. There's something that keeps this whole country together. And, you know, the good ethics in general. It's like, man, we have system. Coming from a European country that's, technically I grew up on the American plate where the European American tectonic plates meet. You realize we have something in America and it's a system, organization. We can get stuff done if we want to. And I think that's a little bit about what I'm going to present today. And being in Pittsburgh, you know, we got a lot of the ingredients for a lot of what the world was built on. Maybe this is a good place to start a new economy. And let's see if this. Just to put things into perspective, you're going to hear a couple of times in my presentation the word restorative. Restorative is really the net positive space that you've probably been hearing more and more about. And to put that into perspective, there's a kind of a race in the world right now to zero. That's sustainability. If I'm running a business, I don't want my business to be at zero. Mayor, I don't think you want your city to be at zero. It means really, green means different things to all of us. That's why green doesn't make sense. That's why there's greenwashing, there is confusion. Sustainability is zero. There's no doubt about what sustainability is. It's not good, it's not bad, it's maintaining. But we do have broken social systems, we have broken environment, we have costs related to it, that's our economy. So we have a pit hole, throwing money down it all the time, but still we're in America and we have a solution. We know how to do it when we decide on something. And here is an example of a conventional city. This we just did for the city of Paris a few weeks ago. And this is a typical city where we're transporting waste out of the city to landfills. Water is sent in massive pipes, expensive system that needs to be upgraded every so often, at a huge cost to very expensive processing facilities. This is a process, not technology, very expensive process. This water is treated with chemicals. Some of that chemical will linger, and that's our potable water. Agriculture, we buy most of our food from a faraway source. Billions and billions and billions of dollars leave our economy every year buying energy. And I want to show you then the solution that we promote is integrated utility systems that combine all of these systems into one. So this is integration. So we have energy, waste, water, IT. Don't forget IT. We don't have economic growth without IT. And I'm talking about 1,000 times faster than what we have today. So we integrate this into our facilities. So this is IUS, stands for Integrated Utility System. This is a system that takes about 8 acres of land, so this is built for urban spaces. And so each individual system can operate as an island, but it's not designed to do that. It's designed to connect with the world. And when we have a regional approach, like we have here in Pittsburgh, which is rather unique, then these systems will talk to each other and affect the rest of the region in a very positive way. Here's a schematic design of a single system. It integrates the water through an anaerobic digestion at the district level. So no water leaves the district. We even rainwater, we can take the storm water into a single stream with any other water at the district level. This is 100% closed loop system. And so we have complete water resilience. There are other, the energy is created through anaerobic digestion, massive energy creation at the district level. And just to show you a little bit what it looks like from the outside is a greenhouse. So the utility is gone. Our image of what a utility system is gone. The city of the future, the utility system, I'm talking about the infrastructure, is designed so you don't notice it. It's like the referee on the field that you don't notice there, we have a perfect game. And here the utility is actually underground. If we aspire to build something that's more, we want to attract talent and people and business from the globe, maybe I would show you a 30-story building, which is an iconic building that the city would be famous for. And an idea of the output, one facility like this creates 1 million pounds of fish in a year, 4 million heads of lettuce, 400,000 pounds of herbs, microalgae, other energy products come in here. So this is a perfect opportunity to connect with universities. The school districts, there are a lot of children don't eat every day. They probably get poor scores at school. Maybe food will help bring those scores up. Maybe we can grow some more talent in the city. So this is infrastructure that is not just meant to be a technological system, but it's also meant to bring the highest level of social well-being as an infrastructure can provide. And we often get carried away with what infrastructure is supposed to do. It's supposed to support a flourishing economy and flourishing social systems. Because if we don't, we have a lousy economy. It's just plain and simple, it's volatile. Here is a specific example of a project we did earlier this year in Minneapolis. This is the actual district. It's close proximity to downtown, about 80 acres of land, so not a lot of land. $1 billion development. They had a light rail coming through, which spurred the idea of this development. The way we came to it was they had a plan, a green plan, and they knew that we were kind of, relentless. We don't settle for average or second best. Minnesotans are not very good at leading. They're very happy at being number four. Everything. So there's a bit of a challenge there, but we were asked to critique their plan. We did so, and we gave them a report which didn't just say what they had done wrong. It was just more about what do we have and how can we reach a higher goal? What's the top of our vision? Can we actually achieve it? Turned out we could do even better than that. And so we were retained and to develop a plan for the city of Minneapolis and now other cities out there and the watershed management as well to bring Minneapolis to a restorative level over time. So this includes that regional approach and resilience. A little diagram here, some of the key technologies that we recommended in our system. So this is again the greenhouse that you see with the utilities on the ground. The feature here is a waste collection system that's underground, so there are no garbage trucks visible. The city of the future will certainly have this. This is important, for example, in the coastal cities and wherever you have flood issues, pests and rodents and other things that we get rid of. Well, the northern states, they appreciate the snow melt systems. I don't think we have a huge problem. I think it's like Iceland here, huh? A little sleet and fun. Very important thing. To some people think I'm crazy, but hydrogen, if we don't learn about hydrogen and get on top of it, we're gonna come behind other people. California, of course, is the best example in the US, but certainly Europe, Japan, anywhere where they have energy issues, but this is coming. The first hydrogen, mass-produced hydrogen cars are coming to market this fall. So this is just a way to emissions-free infrastructure. May I tease you a little bit?
I'm sorry?
May I tease you a little bit?
Please do.
Yeah, I know you. So, yeah, I will. Sewer. Yeah, I hear that. Guten Tag.
Yeah,
we are processing water. We're going to turn sewer and stormwater into very pure potable water, ultra pure, absolutely chemical free. This water with a renewable energy grid, we're going to use our renewable energy grid to convert this water we turn from sewer at night into hydrogen. Is anybody with me that we have free energy in the morning. Okay, we get the bus operators or truck companies, and we give them hydrogen, and we connect you with we connect them with cooperative agreements in Europe or in the U.S. for cheap buses. And so this is absolutely doable. We can start with 3 buses year 1, 6 year 2, 10 after that, and in 10, 20 years, we have our entire fleet emissions free on free energy. Little teaser, but absolutely doable. At last, kind of the conclusion is we are tackling environmental systems, social systems, and our economy in a single swipe. And when we have an alignment, and it's a thought through process, which we all participate in, we have some sort of an identity that comes out of it. Today, we all, every city has an identity, but we're not thinking about aligning these. So when we seek the alignment, and it's a process that we go through, we're gonna have a really strong identity. And this is what attracts people and talent, business and economy, not from Cleveland or New York or LA. It's gonna come from Hong Kong, it's gonna come from France, it's gonna come from anywhere else in the world. This is, it's about competitiveness, eventually. And you have to see my name to believe it, I think. But thank you very much. Good to be here.